Altrincham.
Hi, Altie.
And welcome to a Sunday live show here in the Altrincham New Studio. We are live in the studio.
The new Altrincham New Studio.
Yeah, of course, we've got our new little ceiling, which is thanks to John and...
with a bit of a roof in it.
And Alan yesterday. And it's quite good. Just telling you about a bit of progress and what's going on in the studio. We've got quite a lot to get through this evening, which I'm actually looking forward to talking about. And I think Andy has as well, and I have as well, so hey. So I hope everyone's enjoyed their Sunday with the rain and everything else that's been going on. And also our new design.
Yeah, you're welcome.
No, but I took the picture, you did the design on it.
I don't want to sat up till stupid o'clock on it, but...
You did all right.
But these things just aren't appreciated at all.
No, not really.
Thanks, tell it how it is, why don't you?
Oh, thanks, Andy, yeah, it's good, it's good.
So how you doing, Altie? What you been up to? What have you been up to, mate?
Me? Yesterday, I just had a stroll through where Altrincham, and there was a Nando's stall.
There was, wasn't there? What was all that about?
No, I think it was a bit of a sample. I was expecting people, some people to be at the in the back just scoffing.
Nando's go.
Yeah.
No, I don't think that was going to happen because they weren't giving it away.
No.
No, that only happens if they're giving it away, doesn't it?
Yeah, unless it's weed.
And then eat. We know somebody like that, don't we?
Yeah, quite a lot actually. It's quite. Yeah.
So anyway, Altie, if you want to join in tonight, you can call or text 07-498-345-907. No abuse on that one, please. We had a little bit of abuse on that last Wednesday, but that's gone now.
Yeah, so hopefully we'll have a bit of a clearer evening on there. Because you've got me instead. Well, you've got me on guard. No nonsense like that to go past. The car that goes past me anymore. You know, it just flies over my head, but if it's anything lethal, it just tells everyone how it is.
Hi Katrina, hi Daniel, hi Chris Aki Atkinson.
Hi guys, you okay?
Hi Marie? Oh, thanks for your support, Marie. We both know who I was talking about last week. But should we leave that there for now?
I'm sure
I'll have a dig about him at some point in the next half hour, 40 minutes, but hey, there you go. Chris Atkinson, good to see you back with us. When are we going to get to meet you? We keep missing him by about that much, don't we? A couple of times now. Chris, we need to hook up with you.
Yeah, and thanks for the support in the last, whichever, you know, telling us a bit what's going on behind the scenes of Altrincham, and he's our little mystery guest. He's a mystery person. He tells us what's going on with all the pages, which is quite good because guess what? One's closed down. Yay!
Well, for all the good they did, I mean, they were threatening to do all these live videos, weren't they?
Yeah, exactly.
Since January. All talk and no substance. I know somebody else like that. Somebody else who... I'm not going to go there, because once I start, I'm going to
get... Oh, yeah, so I'll wait till Wednesday for that one, with Andy taking over the Wednesdays.
Well, actually, this Wednesday, I had a lot of support the other week when I touched on a bit of a personal subject. Quite a few people have asked me to talk a little bit more about that, so I think I might do that this Wednesday. So I'll put a little bit on the page about that. Beginning of next week, closer at the time, and we'll see what's what.
Just me and my walk around on Thursday, that was fantastic. I really enjoyed it, and wow, all the views that I've had on there in the last few days, it's like, whoa, Chris is back, yes, okay.
Check him out.
I don't care, Andy, but the thing is, so when I'm on the checkout, so well, oh, you're the guy from Altrincham News, oh, you're the guy from YouTube, yeah, the thing is, so we are on YouTube now. Andy's set that up. We've had that quite ages, but we want to share a bit of more shows on there. So, yeah, it was quite good to do that on Thursday, walking around with Joe, talking about the Altrincham Bloom community side and what we were doing. And I got mixed up with my vegetables, including Sarah Warren's.
You got told off about that, didn't you?
Yeah, but it's like other people sticking their nose in at the same time. That's
what, are your vegetables?
No.
Ooh.
No.
Horrible thought.
Hey, you.
Hi, Matty from Cyprus.
Oh, hi, Matt.
Joining us in Cyprus. Hi, Rach. Good to see you again.
Is that Rach Wall?
Yeah, that's my wrong regulars. Hi, Rach. How you doing? No, I've not heard anything else of it yet. But I'm sure it'll come. It's just a case of bumping into it in the street sometime. But there you go.
Oh, God, the life with Altrincham. Just so much is going on in Altrincham. It's like in the south of course, they've had two shops that have got new shop fronts. Like where Bradford and Binley used to be, that's got a new shop front. And then where next door to Wilkinson's, where the frame shop, they've just moved up the road on George Street. And they've got a new shop front as well. And we've saw some new gossip today as well, didn't we, Andy?
We did, yeah.
The new look building, what would you like to see now? We've actually put a little post on the page on, I think it's another clothes shop, but people are commenting it, saying it's really expensive. I actually forgot what it's called, but...
Flannels.
Oh, hi guys, welcome to Flannels, we're in Altrincham. Oh, sorry guys.
I don't think they sell that kind of clothes.
No, I know, but hi! You know, it's... quite funny.
And this could well be an exclusive. It looks as though work's about to start on the old Bentley's Fish Bar.
Kelly's Bar,
Bentley's Fish Bar, whatever you want to call it. Repairs to have been a lot of scaffolding gone up around there today. So we'll try and find out what's happening there and
how
the work's starting.
Yeah, quite a lot of work's been on there recently. Yeah, what a waste of time.
Yeah. But anyway. Hi Violet!
Hi! Yeah, you know, it's so. Anyway, Andy, let's talk about a bit on your side tonight as well.
What would you like me to talk about?
The bits on your page.
The bits on my page. The stuff that I wrote down to match your. The bits on your
page.
Oh,
of course,
there.
The bits that you. Yeah, yeah.
And the bits that I've not filled in since. That's exactly the same as it was when you saw it yesterday.
But the thing
that's
is.
That's research for you.
Well, yeah. We've. It's all the. Like developed, we've got on our new banner and the little logo, which is cool, which we might be updating again, but it's just there just to look new.
It'll do for the time being. It looks a bit brighter and a bit more summery than the other. That poor old woman in the other banner pick, all on her own in what looked like a wet and windy Altrincham, but there's enough wet and windiness goes on in Altrincham, but again, I'll leave that one there. So, you and Joe have been busy this week for Altrincham in Bloom, haven't you?
Yeah, on Thursday we went round to different businesses with Sarah from Sarah Wansley. We actually went to a few that knew my face, so like, I'm sure I know you from somewhere, and I'm like, okay. But it's just trying to get our feet through the door, which is good, you know. A few businesses next Thursday will be putting a few flowers outside the door. Make sure there's no weed outside the windows. Make sure it's spotless for Altrincham because Altrincham's in the finals for the RSH finals for the.
Are you sure it's RSH?
Yes.
Oh, okay.
Yes.
Well, it's written in blue.
Well, that's it as well.
Oh, is it? Okay. I stand corrected. Yeah, Thursday, judges come round.
I know, another busy day for me. Oh no, I've got to be in a certain place at 9 o'clock in the morning. And then that's where it starts, and then we've got to go round Altrincham, get on the bus. We're having an Altrincham Bloom bus for the day. And then we'll be having outdoor tea with our outdoor tent and afternoon tea.
Freebies, don't tell. Don't tell a certain person.
Yeah, but the thing is though, Andy, we've worked our nuts off for what we're doing. You know, we just don't
work. I'm proud of it.
I know, exactly. We are.
Altrincham's looking really good.
It is actually. It's nice and blooming, as you say.
Except as Katrina has pointed out here, she'd like to see a really good shoe shop in Altrincham. There isn't a shoe shop, is there?
We've got Clark's, that's it.
Is it still there?
Then you've got JD Sports, which sells shoes, and also there's a sports shop just at the top of George Street. I think it's Branded, something like that. I think it's, yeah, it's up there. That's the shoes.
Ask Dan Corrector again. I need to pay a bit more attention, don't I?
Well, we are on Nottingham News, Andy.
What does that imply, that we don't do things properly?
I know exactly. A lot of people just think we're about news, but we're about community. We work for the community. We just do what we can. You know, it's Andy put a post on, a few hours ago about leaflets. We have actually signed our leaflets. And a few people at the fair in Altrincham just said, oh, we've got to start signing leaflets and getting a bit of pennies, because with our studio we've got to get a bit of hand in, you know. But hey.
Yeah, we want to try and generate a little bit of cash coming in so we can better equipment and just do more for Altrincham. We're always looking for donations of equipment. Any way you can help us, give us a shout, let us know.
Well, we've got one of our first donations from Gemma just over the road, over on the other studio. She's gave us some lights, she's gave us the backdrop.
Scary Gemma.
Hey, don't mess that, no.
Nah, she's sweet, Gemma.
She is lovely. Yeah, we'll be in her studio one evening. Actually, I'm looking forward to doing, actually. Because she's got a backdrop, which is actually we should have in our studio, but I'm not going to take that from there.
It's fantastic, isn't it?
Yeah, but we'll use it one day properly.
Hi, Rita says that she'll see us on Thursday.
Oh God, I'm not going. Oh God, no, I can't. Well, actually, no, I'm the timekeeper, so I've got to be there. I'm not going to be late anywhere. We've got to make sure we're there on time.
What have you done to him to make him so scared, Rita?
Oh, don't.
Mind you, I have to say, Rita, I wouldn't argue with you myself. Forced to be reckoned with us, our Rita.
Well, you should. What about you could come back in onto our team?
Yeah, we've got your chair over here that you sat on last time.
Yeah,
the multicoloured chair. We rescued that from the old studio.
Yeah, that's the only thing that we got. And the settee.
The settee with no legs on it yet.
But it looks better on the camera. It looks much better. We're not that low, actually, because we've got to get new carpet and stuff for studios.
I know somebody else that would look better with no legs, and he wouldn't be able to do so much better.
Oh, no, do you remember that big figure we saw under the bridge? Well, you did first, and you put it on your Twitter.
That big figure?
Yeah, that big figure.
But you have a reputation of telling it how it is, so why don't you just say it was a big cock?
Oh, actually, no, I had that on my video, actually, on walking up on Thursday.
You've got videos of cocks? Why doesn't that surprise me?
No, it was live. It was live last Thursday, remember? I was walking up and I was walking around the thing and I said, that's what that... But anyway...
Well, Rita, you're painting, it's just over there.
I'll do the job, Peter. Now look what you've done. You're wrecking the studio.
What do you think we'd do with your painting? Of course we've still got your painting, Rita.
Yeah, there we go. We'll put it on for tonight's live. There we go.
Happy now.
And don't, just to let you know where the Children in Need picture is, that's with Big Gob.
Children in Need picture?
Yeah, Pudsey, the one that we were going to sign and everything.
Oh, right,
yeah. Yes, that's still with Big Gob.
Oh, okay. Apparently we're freezing a little bit, we keep freezing.
Well, it's not cold in here, it's warm in here. It is?
Why, what have you been doing?
It's soundproofed, Andy, the ceiling.
Well, I can still hear these trams going past.
Well, we've unfortunately at the moment we've got no door because we're having another door.
Somebody's nicked the door! Somebody's
nicked the door. But it's alright. Actually, I'm not being funny, but that clock looks mint there.
It does, it works, doesn't it?
Right, Rita, you're having it. Can you do another one for us?
Yeah, Rita, we're.
And here is.
I and that picture up there, I think that one can stay there, that one.
Actually, I like that one. Yeah, that's nice, that. Actually, that's the studio wall. That's the office wall that will be filled with other things soon.
Oh, yeah.
No, yeah, it's going to have the studio stuff on it, like the board.
I have to be careful with you, because I never know, for example, I never know what sort of pictures you're going to put up there. I might walk in and be highly offended.
So what?
That sort of stuff goes on in the studio next door, Studio X, not this one. Apparently. Anyway, so, back to the script.
Yeah, that's the script. Script, Andy. Woohoo! Out of the one of them today.
He's a bit giddy tonight, isn't he?
I am, I'm happy.
Giddy-biddy.
It makes a change, don't it? The people lying about me and messaging people on Facebook about me. Going round with my friends at work, including you and Joe, including my other friends, which is, yeah, that's why I'm happy, because I'm just getting on with my life.
Yeah.
And there's no people getting in my way, because if you otherwise you do. Anyway.
Yeah, can we just say, Craig, we'll give it a mention. He's asked us to mention that his friend's business, Cheshire Pets, we put a post on the page about it earlier on. It was broken into overnight, and all the stock has been nicked. So watch out around Altrincham for people trying to sell dodgy pet food, pet beds, anything pet related, and let the authorities know.
I saw the post on that, that's absolutely disgusting, the way people actually treat Altrincham, the way it is, and it's like people go nicking. What's all that about? Just people just leave Altrincham alone.
Yeah, so please keep your eyes open for any of that dodgy stuff on the streets. Yeah, I was involved with pets today.
Oh yeah, of course the pet. Yeah, she looks good, that picture actually.
I went along to that dog show at Wyvale. Well, I got dragged along to that dog show at Wyvale.
But hey,
I'm not a dog fan, to be honest. I'm more a cat person.
Yeah, we noticed you and you mix it with dogs.
Excuse me. Okay. No, I'm more a cat person than a dog. I like cats. Cats are smart. Cats are... You see, dogs, it's just like, hello, I'm a dog, and that's about it.
Yeah, but the thing is, though, I love dogs.
Yeah, smelly animals.
Well, so are cats.
I'm stupid.
Bloody pawing your bloody finger like this, doing that. With the bloody paws.
Doing what? Is that what they do?
Yeah.
No, I think cats are very clean animals. At least they bury their own shite. Not like a dog. There, take that. Pissing everywhere. I love all animals, but I'm more a cat person than a dog person.
Yeah. Anyway. Yeah, I don't mind animals at all. Just make sure they're not elephants.
What was the last pet you had? Have you still got it?
I've got two guinea pigs, yeah.
Two guinea pigs, and their names are?
Oreo and Buttercup, they're so cute. Actually, I might bring them in the studio one night.
We're going to have animal guests.
Yeah, well, actually, I'll do that one night. I'm going to bring my guinea pigs.
Okay. Daniel, are animals allowed in here?
Yes, because they're getting a cat.
No,
don't. Why is it a telling that's going to be like, oh, I'm going to get a cat! We're going to call it the Woohoo Cat.
I don't think so.
They are. A4 Studios. Woohoo!
Dogs eat their own poo. Yeah, that's one of the reasons why I don't.
Well, exactly. There's a lot of things that come out of some dog that I know. What a shit. But anyway, yeah, it's Altrincham.
Oh, Mandy, thank you. She agrees with me. She's got three Siamese cats. Beautiful cats, Siamese.
Three cats? Jeez. God, it's better than having one.
No. Rita pointing out there's travellers on the old B&Q car park over there in Broadway.
Yeah, that was actually fat by posted by Hale and Altrincham wife. They were the first people to get it, so that's where to find it first. So we shared their page. So thanks for that, mate.
Katrina, maybe we'll find out here on comments, but we don't know if any animals were taken. From I don't think
there's
animals in there.
We don't sell pets in there, it's only food.
I remember the parrot going missing from
Simply Village.
What was his name? Oh, he was a gorgeous parrot, he was.
Oh, it's got a name.
Yeah. Mate of mine had a parrot called Captain. You should have heard the language. Shocking.
That's just funny.
I won't tell you what he said.
Yeah, shit.
Well, Daniel says we might be getting the cat, it's not definite.
Well, sorry mate, just to let you know, we
works cat.
We're having pet guinea pigs in the studio.
Well, we're having a barbecue.
Yeah, maybe.
Anyway, Chris, back to the business in hand.
Yes, exactly, yes.
So, Altrincham in Bloom and the judging coming up on Thursday.
Thursday morning, oh, that's going to be a busy, busy morning.
Okay, now there's still time to register for the litter pick that takes place the night before.
Yes, 6:30 till 8:30, they've got to meet at the Tesco's community room. Is it downstairs? I think they're all meeting in there for 6:30. But you can't just actually turn up, you've got to register before you actually go in.
Yeah, if you want to join in and help out with the litter pick ahead of the judges arriving the next day, you will need to register, and you can do that by contacting Sarah at R. Altrincham. Her email address is sarahw@raltrincham.org, and I'm sure she'd be grateful for the help and support there.
So just let her know you found it on Altrincham News.
Okay.
What Sharon said, I can see Sharon.
Guinea pigs, yes. Sharon loves guinea pigs.
Oh yeah, I've got one. I've got Oreo and Butternut. That's my guinea pigs. So yeah, I might bring them one night. God, know what you made me do. A bloody pet night.
And incidentally, alongside this litter pick, Altrincham in Bloom itself, if you're generally a bit green-fingered or would like to get involved and help Altrincham in Bloom, because I am aware that wherever you stand in Altrincham, from Sainsbury's at one end to Barrington Road at the other end, wherever you stand, wherever you look, you can see something that's been done by Altrincham in Bloom.
Yes, and exactly them lamppost planters that they went up on Stamford New Road, and bang in the middle at the clock.
Yeah, so it's all the little things that add up. I mean, people don't necessarily notice the work that goes on. Of course, it's all voluntary. But taken as a whole, what would Altrincham look like without all the planters in the town centre, without the lamppost planters?
Gardens like Barrington Green, you've got the four-ways, Shaw's Green.
Where the new Altrincham Gateway.
Yeah. Without the clock there, what would it look like without the clock there as well? You know that stump clock thing?
Stump clock?
Yeah. I mean, you know that wooden clock?
That beautiful clock carving, I think, is what you're trying to say.
Oh, carving, I'd love one of them.
And of course, the living wall. That's coming on nice. We walked past that yesterday, didn't we? We were in Altrincham and went past that yesterday. That's really coming on.
And people stop parking your bikes,
yeah,
on the growing wall there, because there is actually a bike shed just behind it, so don't be doing that on Thursday, otherwise you get the chop.
Yeah,
your bike gets the chops, and the interchange will nick your bike and keep it.
Go and park your bike somewhere else, and funnily enough, I know somebody who, if it bends over, would make an ideal place to park your bike, but I keep on mentioning him, but...
Well, there's quite a few...
Can you tell I have a problem with somebody around Altrincham?
Well, exactly, but there's quite a lot of bike parking spaces outside of Pure Gym. I love that gym. I'm actually looking forward to going back there someday. So people beware.
Okay, and this meeting, where you meet for this litter pick, it's upstairs at Tesco, but you must be registered.
Downstairs community room.
Listen... I've got the information here in front of me. Yes. Thank you, Rita. No. And it's upstairs at Tesco this time, but you must register if you want to take part. sarahw@raltrincham.org.
See what I mean? He's just taking over my name.
Oh, check you out.
You try and do a walk around and get more like...
No, I've got the live information coming in off Rita here. Thank you, Rita.
We'll carry on then.
Stop that.
I love this guy.
I'll just sit here and have a drink of my generic cola.
It's not newsy like, is it? Oh, that's alright, carry on.
So, what else do we know, Chris?
There's just quite a lot of things going on.
Are we allowed to say what's going on down there?
No, because they've been tagged with someone else.
Oh, is that the only reason why we can't say?
Well, actually, yes, we can, because there's people filming just in A4 Studios for an online video.
You might have heard some screaming in the background there. There's zombies down the bottom end of the building here.
Yeah. Zombies, yeah, there's a few around the altar.
Yeah, a bit of filming going on down the corridors here for...
a video.
An upcoming film. So maybe we can go and have a sneaky look at that when we're finished here.
Maybe. Maybe we should do a video around the clock. We could do our own video at the clock when it's night and it's all raining and just watching the totem when it's raining. We'll have to do a video so people can actually see what it looks like. Because people are like, oh no, why do we need that now? It's cool. I like it. I actually remember when we did our little video on there. We used to do videos instead of live shows. And it was just funny.
Is that when we were studio-less? When we were homeless?
Yeah, that's our first one. That was our first 6 months of our alternative news, basically. So nothing. I forgot which one it was. When we were on the BBC Radio. That was cool, that. I really enjoyed that.
Right, so we've got August coming up. Next week is August and Goose Green Festival.
In a few weeks, on the 26th of August, which is a Saturday, and Sunday the 27th. I'll be there, I think, doing my... Actually, I'm not going to say anything at the moment, because... I'll be there anyway.
Yeah, I'll probably be popping along there, but... I'll be honest, Goose Green may cause me a few anxiety issues this year.
Yeah, but if that's the problem, Andy, I'll be there just to...
Well, I should be talking about this on Wednesday, but it's like I was saying on my last Wednesday, Chris, and we actually spoke a little bit about this in Altrincham yesterday, about anxiety, PTSD and all that sort of stuff. It's something that you never know when's coming, and it... Oh, honestly, can I not say anything without you dragging it into the gutter? Sitting there smirking like a little school child, honestly.
And that's it's just the way you're going on, and I'm sorry to say, Andy, but if that certain thing happens at Goose Green Festival, I don't care. You're part of Altrincham News, and Altrincham News is going to be at the Goose Green Festival.
I had a lot of trouble walking past Tavern on the Green, to be honest, the other day. But anyway, I'm going to leave that until Wednesday.
One of the places in Goose Green that's got music.
Oh, that was sneaky, that was.
No, but actually, but while you're there, guys, just to let you know, John Drink Water's open right now. It starts at Goose Green, at Tavern on the Green, on the Sundays at 7 o'clock. There you go. His little plug. Sorry.
Are you getting paid for that?
No, but they have music.
Yeah.
And Costello's. And Green Rooms.
Right.
Bob, what's the shame about that one? I just love going past that. I'm actually going to walk past that. Oh, how's your music?
Very, very bitter.
I wonder if the Old Trafford sound outside. Sorry.
You sound like one of those zombies down there.
Oh, wow. I love what we do, Andy. Oh, it's that guy from Altrincham News with the girl. Woohoo!
Finished?
Yeah, it's only music. Ha, ha, ha. House stays alive, stays alive.
In the house!
We're in it, yo, in it. Crystals, it's our show.
07-498-345-907 if you want to have a chat with us or text us before we finish tonight. We've gone for half an hour already.
Or any free music, of course.
Oh, so now long is it spree?
Yeah. You know.
Sorry, I'm just watching.
Is there something down there that's an idea?
No, Andy, no. Just behave.
So, yeah, Goose Green Festival then. I am sort of looking forward to that.
I'm actually looking forward to it as well, Andy, because I don't care. We're going to be there. Altrincham News is going to be there. And actually, Altrincham Unlimited as well.
Big lineup this year as well. And actually, the whole of August, there's a lot of...
music.
A lot of live events in Altrincham this August. Well, actually, there's somebody on the page... messages, I don't know whether you noticed it today, asking if we could put some sort of diary up of what music events are going on in Altrincham. So perhaps we could do that, perhaps we could set up, I don't know, some sort of shared Google calendar for you guys so we can keep updating it on what's going on in Altrincham. That would be an idea.
Yeah, definitely.
Yeah, so maybe we'll look into that and do it. Do you want us to do that?
Actually, yeah, we're going to have a calendar, Andy. Like your daily weather thing on Facebook, we should have one of them.
Yeah,
okay. Oh, don't start me off again. Just happy today. I've had a good day at work and everything, and it started raining after. But hey, it's sunny outside. Well, I'm hoping so. Well, actually, it is. You can see through our new ceiling what the weather's like. It's a bit blue and pink. It looks good, I like it. We've got a bit of studio work tomorrow with the guys putting our new door in. And
fancy taking the door off?
No, but no, Andy.
Daniel, what's going on?
Cool.
It's cool.
It's cool though. Yes. So anyway, that was my bit today. So Andy, anything going on?
No, it's gone pretty quiet on the comments here, guys.
Actually, we should get some cake this week, Dan. Bring some cake if you're coming to the studio. It's your turn for cake.
Cake? Did somebody mention cake?
Oh, yeah. Somebody loves cake here. Yeah, especially carrot cake.
I think David is telling us that we've got a quiet mic. Should we shout up a bit?
Well, the thing is, though... Actually, we're Mike. Oh, not Tinternet Mike. Or
not Tinternet Mike.
Oh, I love it. It's funny. Yeah, it's all good. If you can hear some TikToking, as you can see, we've got the soundproof. And that clock's getting on my nerves. Maybe we should put it in the doorway over there and we can see it.
Apparently John's doing the coasters for the door.
Yes.
And that's why we've got no door on. And Daniel says free cake.
Yeah.
It's the best kind.
Yeah, come on, Dan, bring it.
Just don't tell that guy who lives down the road here, because he'll be on it.
Oh, yeah, the other one.
I don't like him, did you notice? I don't think he likes me very much either.
Sod him.
Well, we have this little game that we play on our personal Twitter feeds where we... Yeah, admittedly, we have a little snipe at each other without naming each other.
So, exactly.
But it's about time that Altrincham realised what this guy was actually about and what he claims to do and what he actually does. They're two completely different things. And the truth is out there.
I have a look at our screen tonight, Andy.
Yes, you have a look at the screen there. 07498345907 if you want to call or text before we leave you tonight. What's happening there, Chris?
Oh, thanks, Sharon. Yeah, apparently she's going to bring some birthday cake. Oh, thank you.
That's a bit late, isn't it? Where was my birthday cake? That was like...
Yeah, sorry, Andy. Last week. Actually, you got a nice thing from your...
I got a nice card of my co-workers.
The Woohoos.
The Woohoo, was that what you call this one?
Yes, the Woohoo, the colleague Woohoos.
And where's the theatre? We're without producer Joe tonight.
Yeah, we won't be having Jo for the next 3 weeks.
3 weeks?
Yeah, she's going to Wales. Oh, it's going to rain! Sorry.
You wish. I think I've got producer Jo with me this Wednesday.
Yeah.
And what I'm going to do the Wednesday after, don't I? I think I might have to bring producer Anthony in after that. He doesn't know it yet.
But you will know if he likes to watch our live shows.
I don't think he's ever seen one, to be honest.
He has. In the last studio we have.
He joined us in the audience for one in our studio, but he's no idea that he's going to be my producer while Joe's away. But I'll put him straight on that. We're still looking for a bit of help on the page, aren't we?
Yes, we're looking for some new crew to help join our team news. Yes, the crew. We need some new filming crew, and we just need like a website crew, basically on that side. And then, you know.
Yeah. Technology's getting better than me again here.
It's all good.
Oh, kids cake from kids' birthdays, even better.
Oh, I love that jammy cake with cream.
No, not jam.
Yeah, jam and cream. Oh, just like to put it all over your body, Andy.
Oh, my, do you know what? I knew that was coming.
Bet it did.
God.
I bet it did, Andy.
I'll just keep your mouth shut.
Oh, yeah.
Awkward!
What a bitch, y'all. Yeah, anyway. Yeah. Yeah, exactly. But hey, we're watching the news. If you don't like it.
Leftover birthday cake.
Oh, I'm excited. I think so. I got a muffin at home. Okay. Woohoo! That's alright, it's getting there, Andy.
I can't tell which way these trams are going now.
Oh, good. It's like me. I don't know where I'm going.
Dan tried to eat all the cake.
Who ate all the cake? Dan ate all the cake.
Now that's surprising, that. I would have expected it to be somebody else.
Well, who ate all
the... Yeah.
Actually, I love them, you know. I'm not saying them words, but I like the little ones. The one what we were going to say we like.
We were going to say what? Excuse me?
No. Woo! We're watching a news. Woohoo! And I'm excited. Woohoo! I'm just making all them woohoos because I missed out so many woohoos! But then again, it could be you, Andy!
Woohoo! I've not quite got it.
Say hi, Andy!
Hi, Andy!
Woohoo!
There we go.
Right, that's it now.
We've not used that for a while.
No, we haven't, because we're trying to bring it up.
Because we're not stupid anymore.
No, because we're trying to look a bit good.
A bit more professional.
Actually, we are. That's what you think, Andy.
Oh, you're a professional now, are you?
Well, I could be. You can off and on. No, it's good, though.
Meow. Okay, yeah, so we're being catty.
Catty? Oh well.
I think he's having a pop at me about having a pop at him.
Oh, really?
But when you go touring around Altrincham just getting whatever benefits you, and then you start shouting about how I'm doing this for Altrincham, I'm doing that for Altrincham,
Altrincham Blue tweeting time. Boop, 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 boop.
Yeah, okay.
Yeah, exactly. But anyway, I'm going to, I think we're going to end our little stream in about a few seconds, in a few minutes.
Is that right? What, like last week when we tried to finish it?
And then you wanted to start banter, Andy. All the banter came out.
It's like trying to get rid of you on the phone. It's one of those, right, back, 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 see.
Oh no, we need to do that.
You put the phone down.
No, you need to do it. No. See you later. No, I'll see you later. No, I'm in Altrincham now, Andy. Have you seen that, Andy? Oh, what I really love doing with Andy. It's like we get emails and things and I just shoot them and I just put them in our little team chat and it's like, I've seen that, Chris, before. You were at work and I probably read it before you and I'm thinking, yeah.
I live in a world of deja vu.
Yeah, exactly.
We all get the same emails, and he thinks that we haven't read them. So as soon as he gets out of work, he's, oh, let's put that in the group chat in case, because we can't live without him. We manage perfectly well while you're working, buddy. I'll tell you that.
Are you sure?
Oh, yes. Oh, yes.
Oh, actually, it's good, though, just to sit down and relax.
Yeah, it's cool.
Yeah, it's good.
Daniel's liking the banter. Good. The Banter Brothers. Oh, God, have I just given us a nickname now?
No, we are definitely not the Banter Brothers. God, there's two of them around Altrincham.
But the Chuckle Brothers, we've been called the Chuckle Brothers.
And apparently the Benders. My ass.
No, it's not my type.
No, you just like legs without tattoos and not chocolate.
I'm not a fan of tattoos.
No, I don't mind tattoos, but not on legs. I'm sorry, even guys.
Tasteful tattoos, yeah. but not. Nah. Not for me. Is that some zombies on the way down? Can I hear zombies?
No, it's alright, they're just doing their own work today, Andy. It's good to have a bit of things that are actually going on in our studios. That was...
People seem to be liking the idea of us being the Banter Brothers.
Oh, love it.
The Banter Brothers.
I'm getting it there, yo.
Yeah, I know you and Gemma have a lot of tattoos. It's just not something that really appeals to me.
No, the thing is, though, we don't mind tattoos. It's just on the legs. It's fine on the other side, but when it's on legs, it's fine. It just depends what they are, really. You know, I don't know. Mm-hmm. But I don't mind tattoos, honestly. I really don't mind tattoos at all.
I don't have a problem with Gemma's tattoos over there.
Sham's got tattoos as well.
It's just Gemma that scares me.
Shh. Hey!
Nah, Gemma, you're cool.
Yes. Be careful on your words, Andy.
I had a good chat in the smoking area out there with Gemma the other day. And we're having a whinge about... they will remain nameless, but we're having a whinge about a couple of people.
Yes.
We'll leave that one there as well.
Yes. But hey...
What about piercings?
They're all right, actually. Yeah, I don't mind earrings, piercings.
Yeah, I have.
He has an Albert.
A Prince Albert.
Which Princess Albert.
I have experience, if that is the word, of somebody, a young lady, however you know, who did have a tongue piercing. But no. Again, though, a lot of piercings. I don't know, I think you can go too far with it. To be honest, sometimes I see people, especially with all the necks and face things going on, and I just feel that it says, it just comes across to me.
I don't like it.
Look at me!
Yeah, it's that look at me, look at my big ears. But actually there's quite a few, I've got a few friends with them ear things, you know, when the...
I've got a small ear.
No. Yeah, no.
I use an ear with.
And then they go big. Actually, they're cool. Yeah, I don't mind them. So. But, you know, it's quite...
We have zombies coming along the passageway.
And things.
Ooh.
It's cool.
You know what, if a zombie did come through that door, we'd be gone.
No, Andy, because there's only that doorway. Unless I was going to say we could climb through the roof, but the roof's been filled, which is good. But hey, anyway, we're going to leave you now, Altrincham.
Before we do, can we just return to the important things about Altrincham in Bloom? Look, can we just say again, the judging's on Thursday, and our Altrincham would love your help on the Wednesday evening for the lesser pick. You can register by emailing sarahw@rawtringham.org. The more the merrier. Let's get this. It's the first time that Altrincham has been nominated for the national finals of Britain in Bloom. So it'd be good to see. Let's get a prize there. On top of the fourth consecutive gold that Altrincham in Bloom are going for in the regional.
Yes.
Judging, which happened the other week, so...
Which we all find out in October.
So we'll keep you up to date on that. So, sarahw@rawtringham.org if you'd like to take part, or in general, to get involved with Altrincham in Bloom, you need to contact info@alteringhamindbloom.org.uk. And your contact there is Sarah Walmsley. Thank you very much.
So, Alteringham, actually, before I go, just to let you all know, have a lovely week. Don't forget to check Alteringham News page at 8 o'clock on Wednesday, and I'll be back on Thursday.
Craig, I did mention Cheshire Pets a little earlier on. Mention it again, they're broken into, a lot of stuff's taken. Please watch out for dodgy bags of dog food, cat food, dog beds, anything pet related that's been sold locally, because they were stolen from Cheshire Pets the other night. So I did mention that earlier, Craig, I didn't forget you.
Yeah, so hopefully we'll have some news on there soon. So as I say, Alteringham, it is just gone 8:45 and we've been live in the studio with...
It's good night from me.
And it's good night from me. So before I go...
Woohoo!
Good night!